This week, Studio 5 welcomes two distinguished visitors. We're very pleased to have with us this evening the newly appointed Lord Chamberlain. Now, Lord Cobbold, what are your views on censorship in the theatre?
Well, frankly, I think there's far too much sex and violence gets by in the name of entertainment. I mean, I go to the theatre to be taken out of myself. I don't want to see lust and rape and incest and sodomy. I can get all that at home.
Lord Cobbold, thank you. We're especially privileged to have with us this evening His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh, Prince Philip.
Good evening,
sir. Would you like to be seated?
This one here?
Either one.
Well, I'm used to sitting on the right.
Well, Prince Philip has recently returned from Africa, where he has been celebrating the independence of Kenya.
Well, not exactly. They were.
You were there, though?
Yes, I was there, but I was there in a symbolical capacity.
What were you symbolising?
Capitulation. Of course, that isn't to say that I wasn't very well received. I was. Mr. Kenyatta himself came to the airport to greet me and shook me very warmly by the throat as I got out.
Of course, Mr. Kenyatta was at one time imprisoned by the British.
Well, yes, but you must remember, that was when we thought he was a Mau Mau terrorist. Now, of course, we realise that he was a freedom fighter.
What precisely is the difference
it's
there?
Very hard to tell, as a matter of fact, especially when you're being disemboweled by one. And that, I gather, is how the confusion first arose.
Yes, I imagine there must have been some confusion in the minds of the disembowelees at the time. Do you feel that Kenya is ready for independence?
Oh, yes, I think so. But, you know, there will still be many links with Great Britain. For instance, Mr. Kenyatta assured me that he still intends to keep my wife on the stamps.
That's an encouraging sign of continuity.
Exactly.
On the subject of your wife, sir, do you feel the monarchy has a useful role to play in modern society?
Oh, good heavens, yes. I mean, it's the only thing that keeps me alive. I don't know what I'd do without it, really. I'd probably be some ski instructor in Wengen or something awful. Of course, you know, it does give the people something to wave at, you know, that brings a little colour into their lives.
Of course, it costs a fair amount of money. For example, you'd travel everywhere by private aircraft.
Well, I would very much like to travel by public transport, but I daren't, for the safety of the people.
How come?
Well, when I once did travel on an ordinary BOAC flight, everybody crowded down to my end of the plane to have a look at me, you see, and the wretched thing became lopsided as a result, and I had to keep running back and forth to prevent us from going straight into the sea.
How very public-spirited of you. Finally, Prince Philip, I think we'd all like to congratulate you on the fact that in the spring you're going to be a father again.
Thank you. Yes, my wife is, so to speak, in the royal family way.
I think we'll say goodnight on that characteristic joke.
There's nothing funny about a fourth child, I can assure you.
Lay on words. Thank you. We're safe now. If you'd like to join Lord Cobbold for a glass of sherry, I'm sure you two must have a great deal to talk about.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello, sir. Have a drink.
Thank you very much. My health.